I have the honor of having my friend Desmond here. He happens to be the CEO of Workstream, and I thought it would be interesting to basically interview him and get to know some of the thoughts that are running through a Singaporean co-founder's head as he tries to run his business and get it off the ground. So Desmond, do you want to tell us a little bit more about Workstream?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, first of all, thank you so much for having me today. So actually, Workstream is a HR software company. It's a hiring software for companies that are hiring hourly workers. Think about like restaurant, cafes, hotels, supermarkets. So we help them to actually hire faster and also better.
Yeah, I think that was a quick explanation, super clear. I think what I was really interested to know is, what is your biggest challenge being a CEO of a asset-based startup and basically running teams based in different parts of the world?
Yeah, definitely. I think the core of any team is always people. So I think I've been very lucky to really have found a very, very strong team. We are all like founders in the past. So the biggest challenge I can think of is definitely time zones, like people being in the US, being people in Singapore, being in Europe or some other parts of the world, having to manage time zone for a call. That is always the challenge that we face. But with today's tech stacks and software that we use, like Slack and Zoom, I think we are pretty much able to overcome that. So
on call all the time.
So pretty much, yes.
Desmond has actually a work call like in an hour from now. So The other question I wanted to know is also, how did you go about getting your very first customer?
Yeah, definitely. I actually went door to door for my very first client. I was back in this Palo Alto. That's where I now stay at. So I just went down the street to some of my favorite cafes, restaurants, and really just asked, hey, can I talk to the owner or the person who runs this place? And I must have done it for quite a few days and found the email of the right person of
so
this.
So not
cafe.
Even cold calling, like cold visiting?
I was trying email and call still, but I think early stage actually going face to face helps because people find it harder to say no to you when you're right there.
I see. So, and I guess what stage of the ramp up are you at today?
I mean, we are definitely still early stage, but it's been more than a year since we have built a team. Now we are a team of more than 10 people in SF, Singapore, and like Asia. We have tens of paying clients now, and our clients use our software every single day, every week, and they've been pretty happy. So, definitely on the next phase of growth. So things have been coming along well.
Cool.
Yeah.
And the very last question is, do you have any quick pearls of wisdom for Singaporean entrepreneurs or entrepreneur wannabes who want to start up either in Singapore or in the Bay Area?
Yeah, I mean, I think definitely is, I really think that the key thing is really to build something that people want. I think that's the main thing, right? You must really try to follow the client, really try to understand what is their pain point.
And really be solving a problem.
Correct, and that could even be, I mean, talking to them is great, trying to ask very open-ended questions and trying to learn a bit about how they do their things every day. You could think about it, like if you're trying to build something in this space for travel, like how do they book travel every day? So even better, try to watch how they do it. Talking is great, but trying to watch how they do it, and because they may say that I love trying to book travel, it's so fun and so easy, but when you see them doing it, they may be taking like 5-6 hours and they may be so stressed out trying to do it. So what people say and what people do in the real life is very different. So really try to find the real pain point and really build something that like people want. I think that is really the core of it.
So empathizing the user by actually really stepping into their shoes and finding out what is their actual pain point.
Definitely, yes.
Okay. Well, thank you, Desmond. This was a short, quick video. Thank you for talking to us today, and I hope you guys found that useful.
Yep, thanks so much, Lauren. See you.